is Michael Zulauf. I have been a member of this church going on 20 years and 5 months, I think, since I was born. I think that's about right. I found out about Snowbird when the student ministry here called Velocity.
Velocity, right?
All right, cool. Velocity, we went to Snowbird, and I fell in love with the place. And God's calling me that I should work there, and so I filled out the application, and I got in. So I spent the last 12 weeks just really growing in my faith, just working hard, and just sharing the gospel. For 10 weeks straight, I was able to share the gospel. That is one of the groups that I was with. Each person up there is part of the SWO staff. We have about 100 SWO staff that works with the students about 24/7. We wake up about 7 in the morning. We go and have our little share groups. And then about 8 o'clock on, we are with students. From 8 o'clock, we have breakfast. 9:15, we have service. 11 o'clock, we have a breakout with them. 12 o'clock, we're with them for lunch. Rec time, we're with them at all times. Then we have dinner, then service, and then share groups. And so we get about 2 hours of sleep a night per staff. So by week 10, we were running on Red Bull, Mountain Dew, and energy drinks for about the whole week. That was a fun week. My 10 weeks at camp working with students has grown me and has stretched me to the point where I never thought I would go. I have so many stories that I can go on and ramble for the next 5 weeks, because there's so much that I could tell. But the one story that has stuck out with me was week 9. It was a Friday night. One of my campers, he pulled me aside, and he was in tears. He was crying. He was freaking out. And we sat down, and he wanted me to share the gospel with him. And so for about 45 minutes to an hour, I walked through the gospel, starting from the creation all the way to the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And I could just feel in his heart that I think that he went home and he got saved because of the time and the input that the staff worked in his life and that the students work in ours. That's just one of the stories that really just impacted me. And because of all the impact that Snowbird has put on me, there's something called the Snowbird Institute, and that is where a select number of students could possibly be anywhere from 20 to 30, however many the creator of Snowbird wants to allow, however many he feels that he can run. They work at Snowbird for a whole year. They start back actually this Wednesday. So I'm leaving Monday night, tomorrow night, and I am going back up to Snowbird. And I will stay there till about August 9th or August 10th of next year. And my time there will be spent working on the grounds, cleaning up, running retreats, and getting ministered to 24/7. While we're in the Snowbird Institute, we have classes that we attend. We are actually going through the history of the New Testament and breaking down each book of the New Testament. That's what our classes will be. And in September, we are actually doing a staff-wide camping trip for 3 days. We're going out into the wilderness. We're going to learn more of God's beauty and God's grace, and we're going to grow as a staff. And then in December, we are actually going to Honduras to an orphanage there, and we are going to preach the gospel to a nice orphanage there to about 300 kids for a week. Anything else? Did I miss anything? No. I think I did. If you would like to know more information, I'll be out in the foyer after church is over, and I have letters to pass out. If you'd like to know more about how you guys can help me, how you guys can pray for me, because I will be needing a lot of prayer while I'm there. All right, thank you guys.